5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's big hit time!
Next 11 books of the Bible. We've already learned the first five. I hope you're reviewing them and remembering them. And we're going to start with Joshua. The book of Joshua is where the walls of Jericho came tumbling down. So that helps you remember. Then we have Judges, a judge, and a gavel. Okay. Ruth was when she went picking up all the wheat. So we just... That's our motion for that. The next six are very easy. Okay. First and second Samuel. First and second Kings. First and second Chronicles. Okay. So that's nine books. Real easy. Very quick. So study those for the next couple of weeks and then we'll move on. Thank you.
So, have you ever been been locked in or locked out of somewhere? How did you figure out what to do? I've been locked out of my house before. Actually, twice on the same day. Thankfully, someone helped me to get back in, but those moments are no fun. So I'm gonna tell you a story. I remember when I was 8 years old and I was in the third grade, and one day my teacher asked if anyone had to use the bathroom before we went outside. So I raised my hand and I went to the bathroom. It was just a one-person bathroom. It was right around the corner. After I was done going to the bathroom and washing my hands, I grabbed the door handle to open the door and join my class, but something was wrong. The door wouldn't open. It was jammed shut. Fear and panic began to set in. What was I gonna do? I started banging on the door and yelling for someone to come help me. But not only that, my entire class had already gone outside to recess and forgot about me. Well, I continued to just bang on the door and I hoped that someone would hear my little voice somewhere, somehow, somebody save me. But no one did. I was exhausted after a while and I was pretty scared. I slumped down and I sat down in that little one-person bathroom and I did what my parents taught me to do when I'm in trouble. I prayed. I said, "Dear Jesus, please help me get out of here. I don't know what I'm gonna do." I began to cry. I was scared. Well, within about 10 minutes, I heard a voice outside the door. "Jen, hold on, I'm gonna get you out." The school secretary had somehow heard my whimpering cries as she was walking the halls. She grabbed the doorknob and pushed the door open with all her might. I ran out, gave her a big hug. "Thank you, Miss Darren," I said. What a gal. So happy she was there to save me. I was soon reunited with my class at recess, and my worries had all faded away. You know, this reminds me of a story in the Bible. Someone that is in God's Word had the same experience of being locked in somewhere too, except he was in real danger. Peter was locked up in prison because of sharing Jesus with others. Not only that, but there were guards around him too. There was no way he was getting out. And I'm sure there was no Mrs. Darren there to unlock the door for him like there was for me. But there was no one to help except for one person. You see, the people in the church were praying at someone's house that night for Peter to be released from prison. They were praying awfully hard, even harder than I was praying when I was locked in the bathroom that day waiting for my release. I know, it's hard to believe. I'm a hard prayer. But you know what the Bible says? In Acts chapter 12, verses 6 through 7, it says, "The night before Herod was to bring him to trial, Peter was sleeping between two soldiers. He was bound with chains, and sentries stood guard at the entrance. But suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared, and a light shone on the cell. He struck Peter on the side and woke him up. 'Quick, get up,' he said, and the chains fell off of Peter's wrists." The story goes on to share that the angel led him out of the prison without anyone knowing. It was like he was invisible. Isn't that cool? He caused all of that to happen. Then, when he got out of prison, the angel left him and he went to find his friends that were praying for him. He knocked at the door, and the Bible says in Acts 12, verses 13 to 17, "And a servant named Rhoda came to answer the door. When she recognized Peter's face, she was so overjoyed that she ran back without opening it. And she exclaimed, 'Peter's at the door.' 'You're out of your mind,' they told her. She kept insisting that it was so. Peter was there. The people said, 'It must be his angel.' But Peter kept on knocking and kept on knocking. When they opened the door and they saw him, they were astonished. Peter motioned with his hand for them to come and be quiet and described that the Lord had brought him out of prison. 'Go tell James and the other brothers and sisters about this,' he said, and then he left for another place." You know what, boys and girls? God answers prayer. And that's our theme for the Big God Story today. Isn't it amazing that God answers prayer? He answers our prayers, no matter how big or how small our prayer requests are. God cares about them all. From being locked in a restroom during recess or being locked in a prison cell, God hears our prayers. Do you believe that God answers prayer? What's one thing you're praying about right now? Do you know that God wants to answer your prayer and he has something to say about what you're going through? He loves you and he wants to hear your prayers. let's ask Jesus to help us with the things that are going on in our lives. Lord Jesus, I pray that you would help me and my friends to know that you do answer prayer and that you do help us. Help my friends with all that they're going through and let them know that you love them today and you hear their cries. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. God answers prayer.
It's so awesome that God answers prayers in the way that he does. It's so cool to be able to hear stories like the one with Peter in the Bible and how God answered the prayers of other people and got Peter set free. It's so cool to know that God loves us enough to listen to our prayers. So today we're praying with you that God will answer your prayers. Father, we thank you for the prayers that you answer and even the ones you don't answer, that you would help us to remember that you love us so deeply and that you answer our prayers because you have a plan and a purpose for our lives. In your name we pray. Amen. We love you.
your Be Kids director here at Bethlehem, and I just wanted to remind all of our parents to sign their kids up for Vacation Bible School August 9th to the 13th from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. Don't forget to check out our website or our app for more information. See you then.